And Halloween is one of my two favorite times of year, so I'm super excited about this. All right, let's jump right in. Okay, so starting up here, we've got these weird, like, freaked out skulls with these square teeth and these wide eyes. And there's something about these skulls that makes me want to go in with a clear glow-in-the-dark polish behind them, and as though I'm a reverse stamping, and then put them on my nails so that I have these skulls that glow in the dark and nothing else does on my nails. How cool would that be? All right, you've got these cute little spidery guys that are, like, little dancing sort of spiders. Cute kitty. I really love the shape of this for Halloween kitty. Adorable. Happy Halloween. Some nice spooky spider webs. This makes me think of like alien skulls. And I love that it's a negative image, so you can stamp over like a beautiful white hollow and have those skulls really pop out. So a diamond check pattern, like a Harlequin kind of pattern, which I think is very, goes really well with fun gothic Halloween-y kind of things. Like I could see this done in black and white and then have beautiful scary jack-o'-lanterns stamped over it. It'd be lots of fun. Some bones, a little night sky that you can go in and lead light or reverse stamp or just stamp it as it is. And a little teeny tiny vampire guy, and we're gonna see he matches some other stuff. So scary. Really cool bat pattern. I love this. And I love how simple it is. Make just an easy manicure across, you know, boom, 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 and you're done. And some more spider webs. And this is, again, I love how she does this. This is a bigger inset of this. So you could have this over all your nails and this on an accent nail with a big juicy spider on top of it. Aw, scary. So all kinds of cool things you can do with that. And we got some little witch legs. And I love this full nail image with the ghost and the little cat that you've got up here. So another really simple way to make a cool, cool Halloween mani. I love this little skeleton guy with his hat. He's got a hat. He's ready to go out. He's all cool. And then jack-o'-lantern. I love the idea of just painting your nails orange and stamping these on the fingertips, and you look like you've got jack-o'-lantern fingers, and that's adorable, good for any party, kids party, adult party, awesome. And you could even do it where, because this is the full nail with the jack-o'-lantern faces, you could have this on an accent nail and that on the rest, or vice versa. Too cool, so easy. And then right along with it, here's this guy. This is a layering stamp, so you're meant to be able to stamp this one directly over this, so you could stamp this in orange and then that in black over it, or whatever color combinations you want. A little vampire mouth. This little vampire guy, he's coming to get you raw. So, and I love that. I hope she does more of this because I think this is really cool. I hope all of the designers do more of that. Gone Batty, adorable. And then you've got your little bat that matches up here with these bats there. I love this pattern, and I like vines. I love creepy, icky vines. And I'm going to point out something else about that here in a minute. But I love that she's got the negative and she's got the regular. So you can do a quick mix and match accent nail with that one, the rest like that. You know, if you've got a cool orange hollow polish you want to really showcase, you can let that shine through there, however you want to do it. Adorable. And then you've got your little witch's feet that match up with your witch's feet up here. Creepy tree. So I think this creepy tree goes along with that as well. And then you've got this little vampire face. So the idea here is that it's just super easy to stamp that over your nail. Please excuse my chipping. I'm about to do my manicure. And then get the hairline and the face and everything right on your nail and turn your nail into Dracula. I love these adorable little cupcakes. Oh my gosh. So the witch cupcake and the jack-o'-lantern cupcake and the mummy cupcake. And that's so adorable, especially if you're like the kind of person that can make those kind of cupcakes, which I am not. But if you are, how cool would it be like if you're going to your kids' Halloween party and you were bringing these and then your nails matched? Oh my gosh, so adorable. And then you've got, you know, standard trick-or-treat with your little Halloweens and just perfect. And then a kind of a little bit of a pissed off alien skull there. Like, I don't want to meet that skull in a dark alley, that's for sure. Something wicked this way comes. And then I love this full nail image with the little skulls and the bones. Another thing that just by itself would be really adorable, but this would also make a really good background image to have something else stamped on top of it, especially on an accent nail. Very cool. And then I love this, like the visual illusion in the webs, and it makes your eyes go all squiggly. That is so cool. I've never seen anybody do that with like webs before. Adorable. And then you've got a few sugar skulls if you want to do something with sugar skulls for Day of the Dead. She has a whole sugar skull plate. So if you, you know, want to play around with sugar skulls a little bit more, take a look at that. But this, if you just need, you know, one or two little sugar skulls, there you go. And then another adorable little full nail image with some bats and that little vampire guy that we've got up here that also I think matches this vampire guy over here, so you can mix and match with that. A little spooky castle and a full nail image of like teardrop ghosts. Oh my gosh, so cute, so cute. And then little spiders, and this is a negative image, so if you have a beautiful black hollow, which I do, I can't wait to use it for this, you can let that shine through and have your spooky hollow spiders all crawling over your fingers. It's so cool. So there's a lot of mix and match potential in here. There's a lot of scene building potential in here. So you could have like this creepy tree and the bats, and then have a, you know, stamp this bat a couple times around the creepy tree. But one of the other things that I like about this, especially if you already have the other Halloween plate, is she did a couple of things that make these kind of like companion pieces. So on last year's, this is Halloween 01, on last year she has the Frankenstein nail to turn your nail into Frankenstein, and this time it's the Dracula. She's got the little creepy crawly spiders here that match up now with this full nail image. She's got, on this one, she's got the negative space image of those spiders, and on this one she's got the regular one, so you can mix and match that. On this one we've got some witches' hats, so in this one we've got some witches' feet, so you could do cool things with that. I love how cool like this creepy vine thing would look with this creepy vine full nail image. Just have that on your accent nail and not on the rest. Super cool. And then you've got this creepy tree, which also goes with this creepy tree. So there's a lot of stuff that you can mix and match, not just on this plate itself, but if you've got this plate from last year as well, or you get this plate, there's like double potential for mixing and matching. And I like that she did that. So if you only have this plate, that's fine. There's plenty of awesome things that you can do with this plate. But I do like that there's like a little bit of extra that you can do if you have this other plate from last year as well. So that's kind of cool. All right, let's take a look at measurements. The full nail images are the same size as all of Uber Chic Beauty's full nail images. So just under 3/4 inch wide and just over 3/4 inch long. And just to give you a feel for how big those little center bits are, and I will have it still on my blog, of course. All right, let's test this baby out. I am going to use my Uber Chic Beauty XL Clear Stamper, and I'm going to use a scraper from the new scraper pack that they just put out. I'm going to use Messy Matching Chalk Polish. I'm going to use white since I have a dark polish on. Excellent image. Perfect transfer. Crisp and beautiful. So another great plate, another, so much Halloween fun, and I will link everything down below, and thanks for watching.